We read the documentation so you don't have to and bring you strange stuff you can do in GDScript, this plush thing and much, much more.
Number 1. Interactable tile maps. You can use World to Map to convert a node's coordinate or mouse position into tilemap grid coordinates. With that, you can easily manipulate tiles the player clicks at. You could also combine it with a Conway's Game of Life to make a Turing complete dance floor. In case you want to know where a tile is in world coordinates, you can use Map to World.
Number 2. The operating system is your helpful friend and you can ask it for all kinds of indiscrete information. You can ask it for the memory usage, you can access the player's clipboard, which is beyond creepy, or ask for the current time, which is amazing for Animal Crossing-like stuff. You can get and manipulate screen position and size. Oh, and you can kill processes, even the ones not started by the game, which is fun and not abusable at all. And of course, you can open a shell, and with that, open other tools or navigate people to your Steam page, for example.
Number 3. Ruler mode. If you ever need to measure an exact pixel size or angle, you can use this handy tool. Have I just found it by accidentally hitting that button? Maybe, but it might be helpful someday.
Number 4. How to move it, move it. There's actually a function to move a vector towards a point in space by a specific length. It is vector2.moveToward or vector3.moveToward. You can use it for the position of things if you want. It is just cleaner and easier than doing the necessary vector stuff by hand, like animals.
Number 5. Static functions. We just found out you can use the static keyword in GDScript like in most programming languages. And just like that, you can call a function of a type without having an instance. You can load the script or use class name to get access to it.
Number 6. You can calculate with colors. This weird little thing was really helpful for that bar up here. You can sum colors to make them brighter. It is also fun to mix them, as we did with this score here. Just average out the colors. And it does not even seem to break if you increase the alpha value above 1.
Number 7. Export var hints. Export vars have all kinds of cool hints to make inputting them convenient. You can set a default value and use resource as a type hint. If one value is not enough, why not use an array like this? The color hint lets you use a color picker. For numbers, a minimum, maximum and step value can be configured. What I have found to be super helpful are flags that are stored in an int.
Number 8. Change stuff at runtime. The remote scene tree is your ultimate debugging tool. You just need to start your game and click on remote in the scenes tab. Now you can see every node that is loaded with all its properties. The craziest thing? You can manipulate them, change properties, the position, delete stuff, whatever you want. However, be careful with deleting nodes. We found some strange behavior there. Sometimes it deletes the nodes in the local scenes. Sometimes not. It seems buggy. Colin Weiser told us that you can drop the line OS set window always on top true in your game's code to ensure that the game window is always in front. Or use your second screen so you can see your changes in real time.
Number 9. Multi-run. Blue Octopus mentioned the add-on Multi-run by Parfoon. With that, you open two or more game windows easily, which is a great workflow improvement if you are making a network or multiplayer game.
Number 10. Geometry class. The Geometry class is often overlooked, but hugely powerful. First of all, you can do stuff that the physics engine typically does, like intersection tests, checking if a ray intersects a triangle, a point is inside a polygon, and stuff like that. That is great if you ever want to do something that the physics engine does not do naturally. Even cooler are the polygon manipulations it can do. You can cut one polygon out of another one or intersect them. That is super cool for destructible ground. Maybe I should make a game with this.
Number 11. How to work with tables. Godot supports reading and writing CSV files, which are literally comma-separated values that can be displayed as tables. Just read them with getCSVLine. Note that you have to import them as keep file. This is often superior to using JSON for everything, because tables are easier to read, write and edit, and it doesn't even need curly brackets and repeating the header over and over 1000 times. In case you ever want to output a table, you can use store CSVLine.
Number 12. Test move. One of the easiest ways to check for collisions of complex shapes is test move of kinematic bodies. It is all the collision checking with none of the actual impact. You can use it like a raycast with a more complex shape. At some point we used it with a movement of 0, just to see if a place is free.
Number 13. Animation player priority. There is a weird little thing about the animation player I just came across. Have you ever noticed that play animation overrides the current animation, but when it is already playing it does nothing? This means that you cannot rely on it being freshly started. So if you want to restart an animation, stop the player beforehand.
Number 14. Error 48. There is an actual error for your printer being on fire. Just wanted to let you guys know, in case you ever find yourself in that situation.
Number 15. First of Us Fungeon. First of Us Fungeon is a Wait, that is not a trick, that is shameless self-promotion. Anyway, if you like colorful visuals and roguelikes, our game might interest you. We try hard to get the demo out this year, and you can wishlist it on Steam. And here is...
Number 15. How to make fur. This add-on by Antlia generates insanely pretty animated fur. You can customize it with a ton of options and even use your own fur patterns. It's so fluffy! You can customize the physics in a ton of ways. Can you imagine making a game with this? I just want to use it on everything, and maybe I will. Okay, these were 15 things, if we counted correctly. You can feed Godoman with a like, this will make his belly full and our channel grow.
Please do it. We are afraid he will eat us if he gets hungry.